U.S. Defense Secretary Jim Mattis is crisscrossing the Middle East and the Horn of Africa at a time when the United States is considering changes to its role in regional security. Among the countries he will visit, Saudi Arabia, Egypt, Israel, Qatar, and Djibouti. VOA Pentagon correspondent Kala Babb reports.
U.S. Defense Secretary Jim Mattis is visiting the Middle East this week, where leaders are eager to size up the new American administration's approach to their regional rival, Iran.
And in fact, when I was in Saudi Arabia in February, their top leaders said that they were relieved that the Obama administration was no longer in power, in part because they felt like President Obama was too soft on Iran.
The Trump administration could become more involved in the crisis in Yemen, often viewed as a proxy war between Iran and Saudi Arabia. U.S. officials have signaled the president wants to further strengthen strategic relations with Saudi Arabia, which has been supporting the fight against Iranian-backed Houthi rebels. Mattis will also discuss how regional allies can help stabilize war-torn Iraq and Syria, where local forces backed by the U.S.-led coalition are battling Islamic State militants. The secretary will also travel to Djibouti, home to the United States' only base in Africa. But American forces aren't the only military in town. U.S. competitor China is constructing its first overseas military base just a few kilometers away from U.S. troops in a bid to increase Chinese influence in the Horn of Africa.
China has a heavy presence. It's not traditional Western soft power where it's a humanitarian mission, because China's got a clear interest in the resources that are there.
While many of the people in the region are poor, the lands and coastal floors are rich with petroleum, gold, and natural gas. Experts say the Chinese have shown an interest in developing some of the poorest areas in the region, where locals are battling a destructive drought.
Well, for more insight on the defense secretary's trip to the Middle East and the Horn of Africa, let's go to VOA Pentagon correspondent Kala Babb, who joins us live via Skype from Riyadh in Saudi Arabia. Good evening, Kala.
Hi, Vincent. Thanks for having me on the show.
Yes, you're welcome. Now, what does the Defense Secretary Mattis hope to gain from this trip?
Well, he is using this trip as a listening trip, is what he told reporters earlier today. He knows the players. He was the head of Central Command when he was in the military. He knows these regional allies. He wants to see what more do they need, and what more can the U.S. get from them to help secure the region as a whole.
And why did he add a stop in the Horn of Africa on this trip?
Well, it doesn't make a lot of sense when you think of it initially. Why would you add a stop on the Horn of Africa? But this particular stop in Djibouti is critical for all different parts of the globe. The base in Djibouti is important to U.S. Central Command because it is just right across the way from Yemen. It is right there next to that strategic Bab el-Mandeb Strait. That strait sees a ton of traffic that goes through a very significant, probably one of the most significant places for trade in the globe. And so he wants to go there to see that base, to see how it is being used for Central Command and also for Special Operations Command, including special operations that go on in Somalia. And of course, it's important to Africa Command and also European Command. So he wanted to be there and include that in his stop as he's listening to see what more needs to be done strategically in the region to secure the area.
Now, you mentioned a new piece that the Chinese are also building a base not too far away from the U.S. military base in Djibouti. Is this of any concern to the U.S.?
Well, it depends on who you talk to. General Thomas Waldhauser, who is the head of U.S. Africa Command, has said that this is the first time that any peer competitor to the United States has a base this close. And so he said that there will be some security operational concerns that he is going to have to deal with as commander. However, if you talk to some experts like Rudy De Leon, who was in the report that I had, he said, don't overblow this. The U.S. is one of the best in the world when it comes to securing areas. They can secure their own base. It doesn't matter how close the Chinese are.
Well, well, well. We'll see how things play out. Kala, as always, we thank you for your reporting. We'll try to catch up with you in your next stop. Thank you. That's VOA's Pentagon correspondent Caleb Babb reporting live via Skype from Riyadh.